It's your boy, Ob Z. Life do it to you. A whole year of breast cancer / cancer awareness. Boom. Today is Saturday. Guess what we're going to be doing today? We're going to be going ahead and listening to affirmations on the way to work. So let's go ahead and get into it. Word is your one. That's what I like doing. Let's check it out. Let's hit that.
How to Play It by Florence Scovel Shin is brought to you by AudioEnlightenment.com. Copyright 2011. All rights reserved. Your word is your wand. Man's word is his wand filled with magic and power. Jesus Christ emphasized the power of the word. By thy words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words thou shalt be condemned. And death and life are in the power of the tongue. So man has power to change an unhappy condition by waving over it the wand of his word. In the place of sorrow appears joy. In the place of sickness appears health. In the place of lack of poverty appears plenty. For example, a woman came for a treatment for prosperity. She possessed just $2 in the world. I said, we bless the $2 and know that ye have the magic purse of the Spirit. It can never be depleted. As money goes out, immediately money comes in, under grace in perfect ways. I see it always crammed, jammed with money. Yellow bills, green bills, pink checks, blue checks, white checks, gold, silver, and currency. I see it bulging with abundance. She replied, I feel my bag heavy with money, and was so filled with faith that she gave me one of her dollars a love offering. I did not dare refuse it and see lack for her, as it was important that I hold the picture of plenty. Shortly afterward, she was made a gift of $6,000. Fearless faith in that spoken word brought it to pass. The affirmation of the magic purse is very powerful, as it brings a vivid picture to the mind. It is impossible not to see your purse or wallet filled with money when using the words crammed and jammed. The imaging faculty is the creative faculty, and it is important to choose words which brings a flash of fulfillment of the demand. Never force a picture by visualizing. Let the divine idea flash into your conscious mind. Then the student is working according to the divine design. Jesus Christ said, ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. This means that man must know the truth of every situation which confronts him. There is no truth in lack or limitation. He waves over it the wand of his word, and the wilderness rejoices and blossoms of the rose. Fear, doubt, anxiety, anger, resentment pull down the cells of the body, shock the nervous system, and are the cause of disease and disaster. Happiness and health must be earned by absolute control of the emotional nature. Power moves, but has never moved. When a man stands calm and serene, has a good appetite, feels contented and happy when appearances are against him, he has reached mastery. Then he has power to rebuke the winds and the waves, to control conditions. His word is his wand, and he transmutes apparent failure into success. He knows his universal supply is endless and immediate, and all his needs manifest instantly on the external. For example, a woman at sea awoke in the morning hearing the foghorns blowing. A dense fog had settled on the ocean with no apparent sign of clearing. She immediately spoke the word, there are no fogs in divine mind, so let the fog be lifted. I give thanks for the sun. Soon the sun came out, for man has dominion over the elements, over all created things. Every man has power to lift the fog in his life. It may be a fog or a lack of money, love, happiness, or health. Give thanks to the sun. Chapter 1, Success. There are certain words or pictures which impress the subconscious mind. For example, a man called asking me to speak the word for his right work. I gave him the statement, behold, I have set before thee the open door of destiny, and no man shall shut it. It didn't seem to make much impression, so I was inspired to add, and no man shall shut it, for it is nailed back. The man was electrified, went out walking on air. Within a few weeks, he was called to a distant city to fill a wonderful position, which came about in a miraculous way. I give another example of a woman who fearlessly followed a hunch. She was working for a small salary when she read my book, The Game of Life and How to Play It. The thought came in a flash to start in business for herself and open a tea room and candy shop. The idea staggered her at first, but it persisted, so she boldly went forth and procured a shop and assistance. She spoke the word for supply, for she did not have money to back her enterprise. It came in miraculous ways, and the shop opened. From the first day, it was filled with people, and now it is crammed, jammed. They stand in line and wait. One day, being a holiday, her assistant became gloomy and said that they could not expect to do much business. My student, however, replied that God was her supply and every day was a good day. In the afternoon, an old friend came in to see the shop and bought a 2-pound box of candy. He gave her a check, and when she looked at it, she found it was for $100. So it was indeed a good day. $100 for a box of candy? She says every morning she enters the shop with wonder and gives thanks that she had the fearless faith that wins. Affirmations. The decks are now cleared for divine action, and my own comes to me under grace in a magical way. I now let go of worn-out conditions and worn-out things. Divine order is established in my mind, body, and affairs. Behold, I make all things new. My seeming impossible good now comes to pass. The unexpected now happens. The four winds of success now blow to me on my own. From north, south, east, and west comes my endless good. The Christ in me is risen. I now fulfill my destiny. Endless good now comes to me in endless ways. I clap my cymbals and rejoice, for Jehovah goes before me, making clear, easy, and successful my way. I give thanks for my whirlwind success. I sweep all before me, for I work with the Spirit and follow the divine plan of my life. My spiritual sporting blood is up. I am more than equal to the situation. I am awake to my good and gather in the harvest of endless opportunities. I am harmonious, poised, and magnetic. I now draw to myself my own. My power is God's power and is irresistible. Divine order is now established in my mind, body, and affairs. I see clearly and act quickly, and my greatest expectations come to pass in a miraculous way. There is no competition on the spiritual plane. What is rightfully mine is given me under grace. I have within me an undiscovered country, which is revealed to me now in the name of Jesus Christ. Behold, I have set before thee the open door of destiny. No man shall shut it, for it is nailed back. The tide of destiny is turned, and everything comes my way. I banish the past and now live in the wonderful now, where happy surprises come to me each day. There are no lost opportunities in divine mind. As one door shut, another door opens. I have a magical work in a magical way. I give magical service for magical pay. The genius within me is now released. I now fulfill my destiny. I make friends with hindrances, and every obstacle becomes a stepping stone. Everything in the universe, visible and invisible, is working to bring to me my own. I give thanks to the walls of Jericho fall down, and all lack, limitation, and failure are wiped out of my consciousness in the name of Jesus Christ. I am now on the royal road of success, happiness, and abundance. All the traffic goes my way. I will not weary of well-doing, for when I least expect it, I shall reap. Jehovah goes before me, and the battle is won. All enemy thoughts are wiped out. I am victorious in the name of Jesus Christ. There are no obstacles in divine mind, therefore there is nothing to obstruct my good. All obstacles now vanish from my pathway. Doors fly open, gates are lifted, and I enter the kingdom of fulfillment under grace. Rhythm, harmony, and balance are now established in my mind, body, and affairs. New fields of divine activity now open for me, and these fields are white with the harvest. Man's will is powerless to interfere with God's will. God's will is now done in my mind, body, and affairs. God's plan for me is permanent and cannot be budged. I am true to my heavenly vision. The divine plan of my life now takes shape in definite, concrete experiences, leading to my heart's desire. I now draw from the universal substance with irresistible power and determination that which is mine by divine right. I do not resist the situation. I put it in the hands of infinite love and wisdom. Let the divine idea now come to pass. My good now flows to me in a steady, unbroken, ever-increasing stream of success, happiness, and abundance. There are no lost opportunities in the kingdom. As one door shuts, another door opens. There is nothing to fear, for there is no power to hurt. I walk up to the lion on my pathway and find an angel in armor and victory in the name of Jesus Christ. I am in perfect harmony with the working of the law. I stand aside and let infinite intelligence make easy and successful my way. The ground I am on is holy ground. The ground I am on is successful ground. New fields of divine activity now open for me. Unexpected doors fly open. Unexpected channels are free. What God has done for others, He can do for me and more. I am as necessary to God as He is to me, for I am the channel to bring His plans to pass. I do not limit God by seeing limitations in myself. With God and myself, all things are possible. Giving precedes receiving, and my gifts to others precede God's gifts to me. Every man is a golden link in the chain of my good. My poise is built upon a rock. I see clearly and act quickly. God cannot fail, so I cannot fail. The warrior within me has already won. Thy kingdom come in me. Thy will be done in me and my affairs. Prosperity. Man comes into the world financed by God with all that he desires or requires already on his pathway. This supply is released through faith in the spoken word. If thou canst believe, all things are possible. For example, a woman came to me one day to tell me of her experience in using an affirmation she had read in my book, The Game of Life and How to Play It. She was without experience, but desired a good position on the stage. She took the affirmation, Infinite Spirit, open the way for my great abundance. I am an irresistible magnet for all that belongs to me by divine right. She was given a very important part in a successful opera. She said, it was a miracle due to that affirmation, which I repeated hundreds of times. Affirmations. I now draw from the abundance of the spheres my immediate and endless supply. All channels are free. All doors are open. I now release the gold mine within me. I am linked with an endless golden stream of prosperity, which comes to me under grace in perfect ways. Goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of abundance forever. My God is a God of plenty, and I now receive all that I desire, require, and more. All that is mine by divine right is now released and reaches me in great avalanche of abundance under grace in miraculous ways. My supply is endless, inexhaustible, and immediate, and comes to me under grace in perfect ways. All channels are free and all doors fly open for my immediate and endless divinely designed supply. My ships come in over a calm sea under grace in perfect ways. I give thanks that the million ways which are mine by divine right now pour in and pile up under grace in perfect ways. Unexpected doors fly open, unexpected channels are free, and endless avalanches of abundance are poured out upon me under grace in perfect ways. I spend money under direct inspiration wisely and fearlessly, knowing my supply is endless and immediate. I am fearless in letting money go out, knowing God is my immediate and endless supply. End of chapter. Happiness. In that wonderful moving picture, The Thief of Baghdad, we are told in letters of light that happiness must be earned. It is earned through perfect control of the emotional nature. There can be no happiness when there is fear, apprehension, or dread. With perfect faith in God comes a feeling of security and happiness. When man knows that there is an invincible power that protects him and all that he loves and brings to him every righteous desire of the heart, he relaxes all nervous tension and is happy and satisfied.
$68 trillion. That is how much money is up for grabs in the next 12 months. Hey, I'm Brian Fouts.
That's your boy, Obz. Just wanted to let you know. And as you're going through these affirmations, I mean, you don't have to, I'm just saying it along with it, but you can, if one really reaches out to you, you can write it down, and that's all it's supposed to, or you can make your own affirmations and just read them into your phone. Man, we got these phones, right? We're not even using them. I mean, just get you, just go to Lil G, download, type in affirmations and print them out and then read them into your phone. Play some songs and music behind. You don't have to get now. You can see yourself getting a little intricate, trying to put a soundtrack in there, do video editing and all that stuff like that. It don't have to be like that. It could just be your voice saying the affirmations. could just be in your car, turn on the radio if you want music behind it. You see what I'm saying? And just record yourself saying those affirmations. It may take you 5 minutes, may take you 10 minutes, but at least you got it done and it's down recording. So we in the bathroom, like this morning, I started out this morning. Same thing I'm telling you guys, and started doing even more and more regularly. When I'm in there, you know, taking a shower, washing my face, shaving. I'm listening. I was listening to Napoleon Hill today, which is very good. It's the sermons in the morning. It's your time. See, we got the time. We're just going to recoup that time. We're going to reallocate that time that's being wasted. Tighten up those leaks. Then we'll find out that we got more time than we ever thought about. When we tighten these leaks up and really access and see where all this time is going. But that's it for Saturday, cruising with affirmations. Do it to life before life. Do it to you. Do it to 2021, a whole year of breast cancer awareness and personal growth. It's your boy, IBC. Peace out.